Hey, what's up? This is Václav. Today I'm diving into the Meross Matter Presence Sensor, a smart home gadget that combines a PIR motion detection with a microwave presence sensing. We're going to talk about how it works, why Matter is a game changer for smart homes, and, as always, how to install it to Home Assistant step by step. Finally, I'll show you how to configure detection distance for perfect accuracy. So let's jump right in. This little device combines two types of sensors, the traditional PIR sensor and the microwave sensor. Why is that important? Let me explain. The PIR sensors are great at detecting motion, but here's the problem. They don't detect presence. If you stop moving, like when reading or working at desk, the lights will turn off. Frustrating, right? The microwave sensors fix that because they detect presence even when you are still, but they have a delay of a few seconds. You could walk halfway through a dark room before the lights turn on. Now, this Meross sensor combines both technologies. The PIR sensor reacts instantly to motion, while the microwave sensor keeps the light on as long as you're present. Together, they eliminate the weaknesses of each. Pretty smart, right? So, before we dive into the installation, let's talk about Matter, because this device is Matter enabled. Matter is a universal standard for smart home devices created by the Connectivity Standards Alliance. The idea is simple. Instead of juggling a dozen apps and integrations, Matter is a universal protocol that allows to register any Matter device directly to platforms like Apple HomeKit, Google Assistant, Alexa, or Home Assistant. It's not a new communication protocol, so it doesn't replace Zigbee or Z-Wave. Think of it as a layer on top. It uses the existing protocols, Wi-Fi, Thread, Zigbee, or Z-Wave, and handles the registration and communication. So if you get a Matter device, you also need to look for what protocol it uses and make sure that you have the right gateway for that. Often, Matter uses a Thread. In that case, I'll need a Thread router. For example, the SkyConnect or Sonoff Zigbee gateways can be upgraded to that. But for this Matter sensor, I do not need that. It uses Wi-Fi. How do I know that, right? If I look at the Matter logo on the box, if it used Thread or Zigbee, it would have the logo of this protocol right under the Matter picture. This one doesn't have one, so it uses Wi-Fi. They could have added the Wi-Fi logo under it, but they don't. Additionally, Matter uses Bluetooth for the installation. It will configure all the parameters for us, like the Wi-Fi SSID and password, and it will register it in the Home Assistant. And it uses a camera to read the device QR code. So it should really be a matter of few taps on the screen. We will not need to configure anything. So for that, we will use the Home Assistant on a mobile phone that has both the camera and the Bluetooth. So let's dig in. I'll show you two methods. I'll add it directly to Home Assistant or more advanced configuration using the Meross app and Apple HomeKit first. So let's start with the Home Assistant. First, open Home Assistant on your phone. Go to Settings, Devices and Services, and click Add Integration. Search for Matter, and because Matter is currently not built in the Home Assistant core, it uses an add-on. So if this is the first time you use Matter, it will automatically install the Matter Server add-on for you. Once installed, click Add Matter Device and scan the QR code on the back of the sensor. And this will connect it to Home Assistant. And just like that, the device is ready to go. Easy, right? Now, if you want more configuration options like calibrating the detection distance, start with the Meross app. It kind of goes against the core idea of the matter, but hey, it's not required, and once installed, it doesn't need the application for the interface. Most importantly, it communicates locally. It doesn't use cloud with any proprietary APIs. So let's do that. So open the Meross app and log in or create an account. That's necessary. Add device and select smart sensor. Now choose MS600 sensor right at the bottom and follow the steps. There's quite a few screens with sort of a tutorial. So step by step. When prompted, select the Apple Home as your platform. Then scan the QR code on the sensor with the Apple Home app, and the sensor will be added to the Apple ecosystem. Then we will skip the offer to share the device with Alexa or Google Assistant. The final step is the automated calibration. It will walk you through the physical installation, and then it will start the space learning. So leave the room, hit the button, and let it do its thing. It will take some time. Then it will walk us through the detection zone setting. We will skip the installation of the pet-proof shield and jump right into the detection distance setting. I'll stand in front of the sensor and adjust the detection to a correct distance. Do not worry to make it right. You can always change that later. After that, the setup is done. Now let's share it to Home Assistant. Open the Apple Home app, select the sensor, and at the very bottom, enable pairing mode and copy the setup code. Go back to Home Assistant, click Add Integration, select Matter, but this time choose Add Existing Device and enter the setup code from the Apple Home app. Now the sensor is visible in both apps. This method is a bit longer, but it lets you configure the detection distance using the Meross app before you bring into Home Assistant. You'd obviously pick one of the two methods. There's no point trying to register the device twice. Now, I promised to show you how to change the detection zone, so here is how to do that. Open the Meross app and select the sensor. Then, go to the detection range calibration and stand at different distances from the sensor. The app will show you how far it detects you. Once you've found the optimal distance, go to the detection distance settings and enter that value. I've set mine to about 4 meters to cover my kitchen perfectly. That configures the microwave sensor. The PIR sensor might detect movement from further away. So if it triggers the sensor, if you walk past the room on the corridor, you might want to reposition it. The device comes with a screen you can install to block an area. And you can use it to prevent your dog triggering the lights. Doesn't work for cats though, I'm afraid. They get everywhere. And you can tilt it to point roughly at your chest height. I think this is mostly useful for the microwave. I'm also thinking to mount it on the ceiling, but it needs a USB-C for power, so it could be tricky. So I'll simply stick it on the wall first and see how it works. So, I have been testing it for a couple of days, and the combination of PIR and microwave sensors works great. Even my wife is okay with it, even though she generally hates automated lights. Partially because sometimes she wants to turn the lights on, but sometimes she wants to stay off and the room to be dark. But I still haven't figured out a sensor that would detect each scenario, because it's pretty random. But the main trouble is when the lights go off when she's in and doing something. But this one made it. The PIR sensor picks up the motion instantly, and the microwave sensor ensures the lights stay as long as someone is in the room. And it also has a light sensor, so you could configure it to only turn the lights on when it's dark. If you find the PIR sensor is too sensitive, try pointing it away from high traffic areas or reduce the detection range. So that was the Meross Matter Presence Sensor, a clever device that eliminates the usual annoyances of motion and presence sensors. Plus, being matter enabled means it's future proof and it works seamlessly with multiple platforms. If you're interested in trying one, grab yours through the link in the description. It contains a code that will help to support my channel and allows me to buy more gadgets. That's always welcome. And let me know in the comments how you like it, how you use it in your home. So that's it for today, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.